I'm back in my faculty view and I'm going to go into the stream, the class stream, and automatically I can see that I have one student that has done each of these and I have zero students still yet to complete the assignment. So now let's go in and grade these assignments. I'm going to do that by clicking on the number of done. Just going to click here and I should see the list of all of my students here on the left hand side, everybody that has submitted the assignment. Let's click on Jane. Here we see Jane's comment down at the bottom. I can also then click on her assignment, take me right into her assignment, and now I can come up here where it says editing. I can change that to suggesting, and suggesting is basically the exact same thing as track changes in Microsoft Word. So if I wanted to highlight this and say BLAH, with a capital B, then it does the same thing that it would do in Microsoft Word. It scores that out and puts the new thing in there. If I would like to talk about this sentence, as I highlight it, you'll see this little icon pops up to the side. I can click here and add a comment. I can do the same thing here. I can either click the comment button up here or down here. It doesn't really matter. I can choose to delete this entire paragraph, or I can cut it and paste it up here. It just depends on the type of editing that you normally do, but that's basically the gist of it. So you have all of these things. It gives a date and time in which you made the comment or changed something in here. So now I've got all of that. I just close it and move on to the next student. I can, if I choose, give them a number grade. So I'll give Jane a 90. That's 90 out of 100. How do I know it's out of 100? Because up here it says 100 points. I can change that to an ungraded assignment, or I can make it worth 50 points, or really anything I want. All right. So now I'll give her a 40 out of 50, which is not the same percentage, but you get the gist. I also can send her back a private comment. So I can give her a little comment and I'll hit post here as well. And now a dialogue has begun between me and Jane about this assignment. All right, so in theory, I've graded all of my students by just clicking on this and typing in their grade. And now when I'm ready to send it back to them, I just come up here to the top and I click return. And it would return everyone in my list. Again, I only have one, so it's returned that one assignment. So now I have graded and returned all of the documents. It's really important that you return them. If you don't, then A, the student can't see the feedback, and B, the document will remain locked, okay? So now we've graded it. Let's drop back into our student view. We'll refresh the screen here. And now as a student, I can see that all of these have been returned. So let's see what we've got. I'm going to go in and say open. And now I see my score right here. But I also see my little dialogue here with the professor. Whatever the student wants to say back, that just to prove the point though that you do have the dialogue that's now opened. It's just like a little discussion board between you and the student. And again, I'll choose the paper that I submitted. And now I can see all of the changes that were made by the professor. So that concludes part 5 on grading and giving feedback in Google Classroom. The last part, part 6, is a quick demonstration of how to add Google Classroom to Oaks. This will make the classroom assignment tool much easier for your students to find and just make it more of an integrated part of your online classroom.